Hey, third grade friends, it's Mrs. Herbay and Ziggy. And I just wanted to talk to you guys a little bit about trees. So I made this PowerPoint, and one of the things I want us to think about with trees is that they come in many different shapes and sizes. All right. And I have here six different pictures of trees. This picture right here is probably like the quintessential tree that that everybody draws, where they draw the trunk, and then basically, here I'll get my little pen here. Basically, they draw the trunk, and then they just draw the leaves as like a big sort of curvy bunch of like a big bush on top of the trunk. So that is like a traditional tree that everybody kind of thinks of as a tree. I also want us to think about trees when they don't have leaves on them, and then we can appreciate more their structure. And in this particular case, a lot of times it's easy to see that trees are made up of a bunch of letter Ys. And it's sort of like Y upon Y upon Y. And as the branches get taller and taller and go out, they also get a lot thinner. Here's another one right here. So that's another way to think of a tree. In this particular tree, this tree has fruit on it. So we can think about not only is it a tree with branches, but it has fruit on it. And the fruit can be represented by circles, if we just thought about it in its basic form. Then there's this tree down here. And this tree has a really long trunk. And then up at the top, we just see some branches. And then we see the end of the branches, kind of this shape here. So that's kind of a different type of looking tree. Over here, this tree is really a whole, it's a little bit different than this tree in that the trunk is a lot wider. And then the branches are pretty much just not even Ys, they're just kind of coming up and out of the tree. And then last but not least, we have the tree over here in this top left. And this is structured similar to the other tree as far as the Ys go. But on the ends of this tree are just kind of like some type of leaves. So this is a completely different type of tree. And the reason why I'm showing you all these different types of trees is I want you to kind of expand your understanding of what a tree looks like and how it's represented. And if we look here, I want to introduce you to this artist. Her name is Eloise Ronoff, and she's a current designer and an artist. And you might say, well, what's a designer? And a designer is somebody who creates artwork, and then companies buy that artwork. They license that artwork to use on fabrics or in clothing or on planners or notebooks or sheets and towels and all kinds of different things like that. So this particular artist, she has done a whole series of different types of ways to interpret a tree. And I thought that they were really, really, really interesting. And over here, she has some variations where she almost like cuts out sort of colored ovals, and then she goes ahead and interprets basically just using lines or in some cases shapes what a tree might look like. So for this week's assignment, we are going to kind of explore trees ourselves, and we're going to kind of think of What are the many different ways that I can represent a tree using lines and or shapes? So kind of take a minute, study her work, and then I'm going to have a little video demonstration where I show you how we're going to proceed with our next project.